Hello survivors, welcome back to another different tier 2 video. My name is Jimmy Shreds and today I'm doing the guide for Halloween event 2024. I'm gonna leave down in the description my socials and my YouTube membership. Thank you for the support, for all the likes, shares and comments as always, and thank you for supporting me through YouTube membership. I'm also gonna leave timestamps down below in the description, so let's get on with the video. Let's roll. So before you're gonna do Halloween missions, I just want to let you know that this is Halloween mission guide. This is not guide for the items and such, like what items to craft and such. I'll make a separate video for that. But let's get on with this. So before you are going to do Halloween event missions, you need to do Playstop mission, which is here. And I'll leave the guide down in the description below so you can do it. You must first do Playstop, unlock the Creaky Corpse LTD building so you can do the mission properly. Now, we're gonna go to Haverbrook Outpost, where we at right now, here, and gonna talk to Kylane, right? And he's gonna tell us that we need to go to Pale Haven City Archives, which are located right here. Once you get there, you are gonna loot the first floor. Usually it's on the first floor, the book, and once you find the book, we are gonna proceed to the next step. Right, so this is the book, we have found it, this is how it looks like. Now, the next step is we are gonna read this book and we go back to the Haverbrook. So now we came back to the Haverbrook, we're gonna talk to the Kylane. Okay, and he's gonna tell us that we need to go to the Ridgebow Hunt. He gave us carnival tokens. Now, we are going to go to Ridgebow Hunt to find Dillon household, which is currently located right here. This is in this block. Once you get inside, you need to loot the entire building, find the key, find the diary, and one piece of a candy. The bedroom key unlocks the drawer on the third floor where you find a piece of candy. The diary will be progress the dialogue with Kylane. So, let's head there. All right, we are in front of Dillon household, which is located right here, as I said. Have in mind, the locations can change due to the weekly map rotations. So, have that in mind. Now, the key should be, if I remember right, I think it's inside here. Yep, got the bedroom key. Now, if you want to get some extra tokens, there's a pumpkin here, which you kill and it'll give you some tokens. I think it's like 2 or 3. Okay, there we go. Now, what we're gonna go and do is go upstairs. We're gonna go through all these doors. Put everything here. We got Halloween candy. Here should be the diary on the floor. There we go. Now, what you wanna do is read the diary. Once you read it, go up the stairs. Attic here, you'll find the candy. The ghost will spawn behind us, don't worry, just get out. Let me show you how it looks like. There you go. Now we are heading back to Haverbrook. Okay, now we are entering the Haverbrook. We're gonna talk to the Kai.
Hey,
there you go.
Hey,
again, to see if he says anything. Now, after you talk to him, make sure you eat this candy, okay? Then talk to him again.
There's no hope for us.
And you see what it says. Now we are heading to the mansion, which is called Fright Mansion, which is located right here. Now let's head there. Also, thing I forgot to mention before we go to the Fright Mansion, it depends on the day. So far, we had to bring Survivor Stew or the Orangizer. So for today, I have to bring the Orangizer, the item for the Mr. Fright inside of the mansion. Now let's go. Right, we are at Fright Mansion. We're entering now. So to get to the find Kai, we go lobby, first left double door, and there he is. We're gonna talk to him. He's gonna give us the weird drawing number 1. Should we read this? Okay, so now what we need to do is go to the find the 4 pumpkins, which are located at the places I'm gonna show you. First one is at the Delbo, second one is at the Kenneth's Hideout, third one is at the Playstop, and fourth one is at the Creaky Corpse. I'm gonna show you the exact locations and everything, so let's move to there. So first pumpkin inside of a double, as I said. So we're gonna go double door across. Gonna go down the stairs, and he should be in the lobby hallway, however you wanna call it. There we go. Talk to him.
How long can this go on? It's not safe here.
There we go. Now let's move on to the second pumpkin. Okay, now we are at the Kenneth's hideout, which is located currently at Framewall Heights in this location. Now this is the second pumpkin. So you're gonna go second left double door and talk to the pumpkin. Have in mind, once you talk to the pumpkin, the boss will spawn.
You're Titan. What can I do?
Bloody Titan, and you gotta kill it. And we got Diet Soda. Oh yeah. Okay, moving to the third one. Let's go. Right, we're currently at Playstop, which is located currently at the double right here. So we go inside and right double door. Here, and you'll see the NPC pumpkin on the ground. Don't worry about the hysteric sound. Talk to him. There we go. Now let's move on to the last one. Right, we are in front of Pretty Corpse LTD, which is located here, as we previously been to. Now let's go inside. I'm gonna go right double door, second floor, then left door. Okay, now bring this door, and there we go.
I miss the sun.
Now once you've done that, we are gonna go to Fright Mansion.
Hey.
Now, let's head to the Fright Mansion, guys. So, we are at the Fright Mansion. Now, what we're gonna do is go second floor. Then turn left. Then right double door. Then four left door, which is here. And we're gonna loot here. And we're gonna find Meat Hunter Jacket. Okay, it's not here, I guess. Well, we're gonna find Scarecrow Emblem here. Usually it's Meat Hunter's jacket, but I guess because I got it from the last year, that's why I don't get it here. That's my guess. After that, we are going to the third floor, which is boss room. We're gonna fight the boss inside. You need to be quite fast, so kill these wolves first, so they don't get in your way. You see this? This is hysteric. But he's much tougher than Hysteric, actually. Run around, what I'm doing. Keep the distance. I advise to have 110 spin speed or above for these guys, just so, you know, safe. Don't know about jog speed. You can see he runs for quite long period of time. Touch his attacks, get some distance, and keep shooting. Just repeat the process. So I'm currently at 125 spin speed. So just to let you know. Okay, he's quite tanky, as you can see. Compared to the Hysteric. Some distance, reload, and shoot. Still alive, just, and there we go. Now gonna find another emblem. I'm sorry, we got carnival tokens from here, from him, my bad. We get the emblem here, which is emblem of the lumberjack, which is, where did he go? Oh, there we go. So now we are going to the fifth floor, into the hallway, and let's loot this. There we go, we're drawing number 4, read that. Okay, now, not quite sure how this works. It just seems to roll dice when you interact with any of the bones. On success, you get the emblem, so just try to spam interact with any of the bones. Any of these decaying pile of the bones. There we go, we find the lion emblem. Now, we are gonna go use these emblems to unlock Mr. Fright's quest giver. Now let's head to the second floor. He is located, it said, this double door, and he should be inside here. Now, as I said, once you get here, he's gonna ask you for some items. It's either gonna be sour stew, it can be orangizer, or Petey's brew, if I remember correctly. That's from last year. So I got orangizer, and I'm gonna get 25 carnival tokens for that. The next quest is gonna be kill the bosses inside of the mansion. Now, the bosses are located on the... First, we're gonna go downstairs. The first floor, let me show you, because you get the master key. So, we're gonna go here first. So first, and let's fight double door. So, we're gonna fight Reaper and Creep here. I advise you to kill small zombies first, and then re-enter, so you have easier time. Ah, we just got Stalker. I'll do it with the Stalker, I guess. This guy is jumping quite a lot, so have in mind. Okay, got the Reaper. Got the Creep. There you go. And make sure you loot them both. So you get those carnival tokens. We're just gonna use iodine, so I'm not to one shot here. Gonna heal up as well. I'm moving to the next boss. So from hallway by double door. Then it's the Zubbler, if I'm right. And there we go. Three Spitter and Tendril. Small Tendril. Watch out, guys. There she is. She's very tiny. Got her. Do the same thing. Load them. Get out. Oh, okay. She's bad. Survive though, because you like the zombies. Never mind, I'm hitting them, one shotting. Okay, now we are gonna go to the, which floor was it? I think it was fourth floor, guys. Yeah, fourth. It's this way. This way, and it was this door, if I'm right. And here you need to fight the queen and Fingerhead, which has armor and everything. Just shoot his body. That's, you can go for his legs. You feel like Stalker getting in the way. There you go, got him. Heal up again. Come back. Get the token. Another token. I'm going back to Mr. Fright. Nice, we escaped him. Yay. And he is gonna give us the another mission. Don't worry about the worm behind us, I forgot to mention that. He's on... You can kill him, but... Not worth it. Okay. Now, the next mission is you need to kill creepy clowns, which the best way to do it is by doing the purple zone. I'm gonna see if there is any purple zone with the clowns, and there it is. There is one. And there is another one. So, the best thing is go to the purple zone and just pull them out of the purple zone and kill 30 of them. Now, let's head and do that. Let me show you. Okay, now we are in front of the purple zone. Now we're gonna get inside the purple zone, find the clown zombies, and just get out of the purple zone so it doesn't count. So you can get 30 zombie kills. But we do not end the purple zone with that. There you go. And you are free to shoot from here. And just keep repeating this until you get 30 of them. Very simple. Now, once we're done with the clown zombies, we're gonna go back to Mr. Fright. Yet another quest. And now he's gonna ask us to kill Fright Frankenstein, which is, we currently have the purple zone with him, which is right here. So we're gonna go do this. Have in mind, this one, what I'm about to do is level 40 purple zone. Level 51 is much tougher, he's faster. I advise you to have at least, to be safe, 115, 120 spin speed. So you can get away from him, because he doesn't stop running, but I'm gonna be able to kill this one really, really fast because he's slow. Very slow compared to level 51. Kill these zombies first, because they're getting in the way. Oh, my bad, got out of the purple zone. Let's put them here. Bro, really easy. Never mind, I have very powerful gear, so it's gonna be a different story for you guys if you are fairly new to the game. Do this in the groups, because you probably won't be able to do it solo. This is the last one. Where are you, sir? And we're gonna loot this guy. And we're going back to Mr. Fight. Now, since we've done that, okay, we're gonna get another carnival tokens. Now, he's gonna ask us to go to the locations where we're gonna fight him. We need to find Mr. Fright or Kai, I can't remember who it is, but anyways, there are locations. We need to go to the Double PD, then Creaky Corpse, and Comrade Sun. They're gonna be located in the lobby. You just talk to them. Once you talk to them, you go back here and talk to Mr. Fright, and he's gonna give you a level 60 elite enhancer. Have in mind, all these missions, since the mission where you bring him premium food, and then you kill the mission where you have to kill the bosses inside, then you do the purple zones, all these missions till the level 60 enhancer can be done every day. So once you unlock the mansion, you just have to do this every day if you want to. You don't have to. If you want, you can farm just purple zones. Now let's head to the locations. Okay, we're inside. We are in front of Devil Police Department. Just gonna go inside. So we're gonna find Mr. Fright here. First location, and talk to him. He doesn't have. He's headless. Okay, now let's move on to the second location, which is Creaky Corpse. Right, we are outside of Creaky Corpse. Now, I'm gonna go inside, and he's gonna be in the lobby. And now, we are moving to the last location, which is Comrade Sun. Alright, we are at Comrade Sun right now. So, he's gonna be in the lobby as well. Once you talk to him, you just go back to the Fright Mansion. And talk to the Mr. Fright, where we have seen him. Now, let's head to the Fright Mansion. So now you get back to the Fright Mansion, to Mr. Fright. The owner, you talk to him, he's gonna give you Elite Enhancer, I already did. Now, apparently, this is not confirmed, I cannot say. You might only get Elite Enhancer once per character, so you cannot do the Elite Enhancer every day. That's apparently how it is. I cannot confirm this, but that's apparently how it is. And we have come to an end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope the information was useful. And also want to give you one more tip is, which you don't have to do these missions if you don't want to, but you can do them if you want every day, because there are other ways to earn carnival tokens, which is purple zones. They will be the best if you have multiple characters. Just run to the purple zones, like level 51 gives you 20 carnival tokens, the lower, the second one gives 12, and then I think the other one is like 10. So if you have multiple characters, just run through the purple zones. Even if you have one character, that's still gonna be quite good once you're done with the missions, or you can do the missions if you want. So that'll be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I'm gonna leave down in the description my socials, and also, you know, Twitch, where I stream currently. I'm live recording this while I'm live, and also gonna leave my YouTube membership if you wanna support me through that. I really appreciate you all who are supporting me through YouTube membership, and I'll see you guys in another video, different here too. Till next time, peace, survivors.